Welcome back. As we earlier said in our intro, that the state is doing its utmost efforts, and especially with the new cabinet, and spending efforts and setting plans to be able to attract more foreign and domestic investments into the industrial sector in particular. And of course, it's the strategy to achieve more economic development. We're very delighted to be having with us over the phone our dear guest, Mr. Mustafa Waley. He's former general manager of the Federation of Egyptian Industries. Good morning, Mr. Mustafa.
Good morning.
How are you doing, sir?
Thank you very well. How about you?
I'm fine. Thank you so much. It's my pleasure to have you. Let us first shed light over the importance of the industrial sector in achieving economic stability and more growth in development. Of course, industry is part and parcel of economy. It could be even the backbone of economy. How important is industry to any state?
Well, actually, if we look at the industry, or we should look actually to the industry as the prime mover for the economy in the whole world, even when it comes to agricultural, the service, trade, and everything. Because industry is the creator, is the prime mover, where you can have what you can deal with, what you can exchange it, what is needed for life in general. That's very important. And the more the development of any country, the more actually we find the industry is developing. And that's essentially my understanding. And I think it proved itself over the years, especially in the last two or three decades, especially when it comes for the developing countries like us.
Right. And of course, Egypt have been adapting to more very important industries before and for almost years and years. But for the last 10 or 20 years, industry have developed and diversified into many channels, not a specific industry. And of course, the Egyptian administration have been setting forth industry as a first priority to an economic growth. If you like to elaborate.
That's, first of all, that's very true. That's really true over the years. And it was a success story in general, and a really successful story when it comes to the development which we have witnessed as a society and as a nation over at least the last 30, 40 years up to now, even before, as a pioneer in the industry in Africa. I'm talking about the early century, the early 20th century. So from this start, from this outlook, we should be very happy. I mean, that should be make us happy, but we need much, much more than have been done over the years. And fortunately, it's affordable, because the development in the technology, the development in science and application of science, especially when it comes to industrial applications and industrial needs, has tremendous steps in the right direction, which actually we are trying to cope with. So in general, we have been successful in doing the following, in grasping the essential aspects of having a developing course for industry. I'm talking general now, not specific industries in itself. I mean the concept itself of the industry. And as much as we have from the most essential, which makes the industry success story, is what we call in nutshell localization, which means that first of all, that you have the raw material needed for certain end product. And we manage in this, we manage actually successfully according to the situation which we have been through. And from this, we can get to other, where we can get to how you can at least get some semi-finished products, and then you have you can finish it here in your facilities, industrial facilities, and then you have an end product. And you can, you can, I mean, honestly and frankly, you say that it was at least assembled in Egypt. or partially produced or manufactured in Egypt. This is altogether will directly increase our GDP, because always, and it will be, and right now we are, the industry is the biggest contribution to our GDP percentage-wise. We want to increase it because we know that is the only way, actually, to increase or develop the status of the society, our Egyptian society at large.
Right. Of course, you raised a very important point, Mr. Wali, which is the localizing industry. Of course, localizing industry is the backbone and foundation of any growth development. When we depend on ourselves in having all the commodities sufficient, being localized and industrialized inside our country, of course, this is a source of a huge venue to Egypt, and also it's going to attract investment. And you can add many other, open opportunities for the world localizing industries. Of course, you talked about also material, the raw materials. And Egypt is one of the richest countries with raw materials on many fronts also. How can we make the best use of those two elements?
Well, talking about localization, this is a very big issue, but we are familiar with it. I mean, the industrial community and over long time of history and application and work on the ground. And we have very successful stories when it comes fully a localized product or end product, especially to have a finished product. The only thing is that, frankly speaking, and this is a fact, you cannot have fully localized even for the developed country, the highest developed country. You can't have all the product needed for your society to a big percentage to be localized. But the most important thing, how you can make use of the concepts or the ingredients which would, can help you to have localization of a certain item. And the more this item or this product is needed for your community and for other communities, in this case, which means that you can have it and you can have it to the best quality according to the latest technology and according to international standards, then you can export it. Then you will be satisfied. Then you can hit two birds in one issue. You have local satisfaction, local demand satisfaction, and the excess, or you can even increase the return revenue by exporting to the markets around you. In this case, as we need to have foreign currencies to compensate us in a certain areas where we have to buy these or import these items, then this will be a good help. This will be a great help. Localization always is helping in this. But by the way, let's be frank. It's not an easy story. It's not an easy issue. But it is possible. And there are success stories. And we have specific industries where we have the localization is up to 100%.
Right. Of course, Mr. Wali, talking about industry is directly linked with agriculture. If you are achieving agricultural development, then we can have, this is going to empower and enforce industry on many fronts. Also with energy, with many other industrial or let us say activities that are so essential to achieve a successful industry. In order to be able to excel in a specific type of industry or five specific industries, then we could have some agricultural projects, we can have some minerals, we can have some energy resources, and Egypt is very rich in all those sources. Egypt is very popular for its cotton, and it's one of the most expensive materials sold abroad in the Western world. Egypt is very rich also in the energy sources, and also it's very rich in minerals and many other sources. So what exactly are the open opportunities for specific type of industries for Egypt when we talk about those things?
Well, let's take the basic in your introduction in this section. It is the agriculture, right? This is what we started with, you know, you started
right.
with.
Agriculture.
In my opinion, and I mean, not only me, I mean, those who have seen how things are delivering, and it's a fact now. It is the industry which has contributed heavily and in all aspects for the success of a viable agriculture in general, meaning that the development and the creation of the of the systems, the industrial systems, which will increase the areas of planting, which will increase the area, the capacity of yield collection, you know, or cropping, or planting, or distribution, you name it. The whole process is needed for vast and intensified agriculture, especially in countries where the population is a critical issue, like ours now. So the demand for agro-products, agriculture in general, and agro-product industry is the greatest tool which will help and will maintain and develop even the demand from the agricultural sector. I'm talking actually, this is a fact now, you know. I can give you one example. Imagine for the vast areas of land where you need to irrigate it, and you need to irrigate it while you have to be very careful for application of the water. Even to the drop level, you know, you have to calculate to the drop of water needed, no more. If you apply it, it's the needed. Imagine you are talking tens of thousands of hectares of agriculture or agricultural areas can be developed, or let's say reclamation. Without the system of pivot irrigation, you can't have this. And now this is fact of life, and we have it in Egypt, and it helped us a lot, especially in the very big project in South Egypt and also in the North. That's an example. I'm taking the biggest and the most important and, seen and noticeable by anybody in the engineering, in the industry and the engineering in agriculture as agriculture activity and product.
Exactly. So that, in other words, would what you're saying is very important in the sense that it is directing us to talk about the strategies for industry, especially after the latest new cabinet reshuffle, and those in charge are setting every effort to be able to develop with the investment in Egypt and with industry and with the economic growth and everything. So talking about all these elements to collaborate together in order to achieve successful industry, we need a strategy for this industry. If you like to talk to us about the new strategy plan that is set for industry and the importance of launching it.
I can't get into details because I don't have the details, but at least, you know, the headlines and the directives are clear, and it was announced, and even in the new cabinet, which I really wish for them all the best of success in this phase of our Egyptian history now and the challenges we are facing. So the directives and the slogans and the motives are already known. But the always the problem is in getting this into a real workable plans work plans and to be implemented. And we are talking about multiple and hundreds of issues when it comes to the basic things when it's needed, for example, for any successful project, even industrial project or whatever, you will find that energy is an essential now. Then you will see that out of the industry itself, which you will know and can be done, but you have to supply, you have to provide energy and enough energy and continuous energy. This is something. So it's a very big story. But fortunately, we in Egypt have our successful record over the years, because it's evident. Of course, it's not 100% or even that margin which we need. We would like to have it as Egyptian, but we have success stories over the years. The only thing is that the demand for more success, the demand for more supply is there always, and it's increasing year by year, and that's another story. But let's proceed from where we have gone, we have reached when it comes to the development in the techniques, in the capacities, in getting the latest technology. And the most important thing, we should never, ever, and we should give more attention for more qualified labor, in one word, qualified labor, industry, especially when it comes to industry. And we should provide as much as we can for the science, for the scientific side of our people, of our generation, of our youth, especially those who are oriented, should be oriented towards industry. This is essential because we have in the history, we have just recent history, the Asian tigers. The Asian tigers, of course, they were supported and helped and assisted by the developed countries. That's a well-known story, and that's a fact. But they paid much of attention, the more attention to their localization, and in this case was first the human resources development for industrial demand.
Right. Again, you are raising also points, important points to point our fingers towards more essential elements that are related with industry, like, for example, the qualified labor. Qualified labor would require vocational training, for example, and would require even industrial institutions, technical institutions, to be able to qualify them and train them. However, the most qualified labor is the Egyptian labor, and the most successful Western industries are being taken inside Egypt and then again taken to their original houses in the Western world and in other places like Egypt. But talking about qualifying all the situations for a successful industry, we need also to link industry not only to agriculture but also to successful trade process and to successful investment process and to successful economic plans. And that is all going to lead to successful Egyptian currency that is going to improve. So how important is equalizing or working, sparing efforts on all those fronts on equal foot?
You were enumerating many items which actually make the matrix of the economy at large, generally. But again, if we get to the industry, I agree with you that all what you have said is really correct. But let's focus. Let's get sectoralized, get into sectors, and this happened, you know, and it's possible. So every sector will be required to see what he needs in the first place, and then how much he can find around, how much he can afford, or how much he can get out of the available in the country. I mean, when it comes to energy and finance, labor, and all this. So in this case, we will try to match as much as we can. just to increase the startups, the more startups we will have, and then the process of developing can go on. But let's, at least as much as we can, let's get back to the basic, is how to start successfully as much as we can, even when it comes to large industrial setups and small and medium enterprises or industries or entrepreneurs working on their own, few people, few young men make their own project. When they will find that the country is providing them at least with the right answer for any question of this and the facts which they need, in this case, you will start successful. And it's not a hard job, it's an easy job, because we have a lot, a tremendous brains and talented youth and experienced people in all fields of life, including, of course, engineering, technology, management, everything is there. Plus right. We are Egyptian, we can, yes, we can. Yeah.
Right, and we also have former successful experiences.
This is what I meant, yes.
And industrial experiences.
Yes.
So
yes.
We can...
Valuable experiences, and in very sophisticated fields, and with a world record in some areas, actually, yes.
Right, but also, how important is setting a plan like learning from our experiences or taking other successful similar experiences that we could be familiar with? I mean, there are different successful experiences that are set in the whole world, and we can pick and choose whatever we like, and we can apply it over here. Let us talk about the small and medium enterprises and the macro economies. How important is it to start with very small economies, very small industries, and this has been proven very successful in China, for example.
You talk China, this is another story, but believe me, it has all what we have been talking about, they manage. But the only thing that they have some time, and they got the support, honestly, they got the support of the first world, of the developed world. Tremendous support. I mean, those who knew the story with the investment in China, it's unbelievable. But anyway, I would like to highlight something very important. You were talking about how let the people get together, how to raise the awareness of what we can do. Egypt right now, we have a very successful and a very reputable organization. It has even its, success stories of the history. It was established, this institution or this gathering was established in 1920. They were celebrating their first and in centennial few years ago. This is the Federation of Egyptian Industries. Imagine we had industry and people, industrialists. Thinking people with the help of the foreign partner, but the Egyptians were there to start industry since 1920 at least. Officially it was announced in this Federation of Egyptian Industry. This could be actually, if we look for such institutions, there are many, but this is the most important of them when it comes to the industry, by the way, because it represents all the industrial sectors in Egypt. Mm-hmm. We should give, as a state and as a private sector and as even people of intelligence, people of social science, background and inclination, they can get together and have out of this institution a reference for the best practices, let's put it in a professional way, best practices in industry at large.
Right. On this note, of course, Mr. Mustafa Waley, Engineer Mustafa Waley, former General Manager of the Federation Egyptian Industries, thank you so much talking to us on the breakfast show, and we're going to go to a short break and we'll come to continue the breakfast show, so stay with us.